So there's a word that comes to mind here. Let me.
For more training on building and attracting a blissful marriage, please visit www.lolaandola.com.
So there's a word that comes to mind here. Let me pull it on the screen. When it comes to attraction, when I put this on the screen, symptom.
All right.
Okay. So when you meet a person for the first time, it's not really a symptom.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like it feels like it's a cause.
Mm-hmm.
Or if somebody tells you like, "How did we meet?" Right?
Mm-hmm.
You start telling about the attraction
mm-hmm.
as the first energy that
right.
happened between chemistry that happened between us.
Right.
Right. That's so it feels like it's the cause, right? But the truth of the matter is that the cause of it is newness. And then obviously you're attracted to that person physically too, right? But the newness was a catalyst. If you had known that person, maybe you won't feel that level of attraction.
Right.
Right? That level of attraction. So it's not exactly a symptom if you're meeting the person for the first time, but it is a symptom of
mm-hmm.
newness,
mm-hmm.
right? But especially when you've already been in a relationship.
Right.
Attraction, maintaining attraction in that relationship is a symptom of a lot.
Right.
Dynamics of your relationship.
Mm-hmm.
What is going on with your relationship?
Mm-hmm.
When I say relationship, it takes two.
Right.
Right. So now when we're talking with respect to you, we're talking about the other person. How does that other person see you? You know? So it's a little bit tricky there. Is it a symptom?
Mm.
Or is it... No, attraction is always a symptom of either newness,
mm-hmm.
like it's exciting, or, you know, or listen, I treat you so well in His Needs or Her Needs, the book by, I forgot his name, they call it something else. I think love something, but in Five Love Languages, they call it love tank.
Love
one
tank,
of them yeah. call it love tank, the other one call it love something. Basically, you're feeling it. You're always feeling it,
right?
Because you're going to find it. You're gonna need that.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna need that love tank that you're feeling. I say you go into a relationship to give because you're actually feeling a love tank. Because there's gonna be moments in life crisis, things are gonna happen.
Yeah.
That naturally you're just not in the mood.
Right.
Because remember, there's no newness anymore.
Right.
This is just me and you now
mm-hmm.
in this world that we've chosen to be together. Right.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever is in that love tank is gonna be useful in those moments.
Yeah, because, you know, oftentimes you will see people just be numb.
Yep.
They might be able to sustain it until their kids
yep.
leave the nest. Once the kids are gone, then you now be hearing, oh, well, we're filing for divorce. Oh, no.
Yeah.
Babalagbaja has moved to Malaysia. Mamalagbaja
yep.
is in China.
Mm-hmm.
Like, okay, what is going on here? Because they can't sustain that relationship.
Yep.
Because there's no more attraction in the relationship.
Yeah, we're going to talk all about of that too. The idea of you poured all that energy into your children, but now the children, were you pouring energy into your children or you were taking from them?
Hmm.
That's a question, you know, that we need to have. You know, were you pouring energy into them or you were taking from them? You were receiving from them as well, you know, because children, you know, there's a sense of accomplishment. You know, that you have, you know.
For more training on building and attracting a blissful marriage, please visit www.lolaandola.com.